25 years of covering the Atlantic Coast Conference, Raycom Sports and the Lincoln Financial Sports Network presents Miami and Maryland. It's a matchup showcasing two of the ACC's most explosive players, like Miami's Jack McClinton, who leads the league in three-point field goal percentage, and Maryland's DJ Strawberry. The Terps' time-tested veteran leads Maryland in scoring. Well, tonight, they go head-to-head. It's Miami and Maryland at the Comcast Center in College Park, Maryland. The Maryland Terrapins have won five straight games. They come in with a record of 14-2, but now they start a stretch of 15 straight ACC games. Miami, on the other hand, is coming off a loss. They're 8-8, 1-1 in the conference, but tonight should be special. It's Miami and Maryland. The tip-off is coming up next from College Park, Maryland.
Somewhere between starting a business and growing one, you're going to need a bank. We'd like to be it. The small business advisors of RBC Centura. With more proactive advice, proven ideas, and dedicated service than you'd expect from a bank, RBC Centura, let's do something giant.
The 2007 Motor Trend Truck of the Year, the all-new Chevy Silverado.
Give me the rock. You want the candy?
You can't have the candy. They call me the bus driver, kid, because I'm about to take you to school. Vader! Oh! Oh!
Man, I send it to everybody.
Hey.
What are you guys looking at?
Nothing.
Catch My Circle Mania. Text HOOPS to 84353 for a chance to win $100,000.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by Chick-fil-A, by Ford, by Food Lion, by Alltel, by Advance Auto Parts, by Pepsi, by Geico, and by Budweiser.
Just about set to go here in College Park, Maryland. Tim Branton, Dan Bonner with you. It's paramount in the ACC, Dan, to win at home.
Tim, that's always been the formula. You steal whatever you can on the road, but you win at home. And for the Maryland Terrapins, their first home game in the ACC tonight.
Take a look at the Food Lion starting lineups. We'll run you through there very quickly. First for the Miami Hurricanes. This is a team that likes to run. They like to shoot from the outside. It's a team that is loaded with outside shooters. We told you about Anthony Harris and Jack McClinton. There's Brian Asbury, Dwayne Collins, and Keaton Copeland. That's your starting lineup for Miami. For the Maryland Terrapins, it all starts with DJ Strawberry. He's their leading scorer. Gravis Vasquez, Mike Jones, Akenny Obekwe, and James Gist. Underway in College Park, the Maryland Terrapins win the toss, and they will win the tip and have the ball first. Here we go. Strawberry fade away short.
Each team opening in a man-to-man defense.
Harris will do most of the ball handling. This is Copeland. Keep an eye on number 33, McClinton, because Strawberry will be guarding him all night, trying to stay with him and deny him the pass like that. Ball's loose. Harris, this is for three. Copeland with the rebound, kicks it out. McClinton has a look. It's blocked, and Strawberry's called for the foul. While we have a chance, take a look at our four keys to the game, Dan.
Well, the Miami Hurricanes they have won 85% of their games over the career of Anthony Harris when he scores 15 points or more. So point guard play is going to be critical, I think, for the Hurricanes tonight. And for the Maryland Terrapins, you mentioned Miami can be a very, very good three-point shooting team. Maryland, one of the top teams in the conference in three-point field goal defense. I think it's going to be very important for them to play well out there tonight.
That's a big foul against Strawberry. It's first. McClinton at the line makes his first, and he's a 91% free throw shooter. He's had 7 20-point games this season. And Maryland now trails 2-0.
And here's Miami with some pressure. And they drop back. Miami showing a zone defense, 2-3 zone.
Vasquez, the freshman, penetrates, dribbles into trouble.
Tim, that's a good point. Penetrated, but he did dribble into trouble. You draw the defense, find the open man.
Right now, it's all Miami. Good putback. So Collins makes it a 4-0 game. And this is for three by Jones. 1-for-1 beyond the arc.
And that's a weapon in the Maryland arsenal that sometimes isn't there for the Terrapins, but they're an excellent three-point shooting team on the season so far.
And a turnover. Terps will run. Vasquez left side. Terps lead 5-4.
That's what Maryland wants to do. Really get out and go. Create those easy opportunities in transition. Maryland now coming with some pressure.
Yeah, one thing that's been interesting about the Terrapins this year, although you got a couple freshmen that are doing a lot of the ball handling, they don't panic. There's a look at Frank Haith, head coach of the Hurricanes in his third season at Miami. Has a record of 42-37 in Miami.
Frank is an excellent basketball coach who was able to talk to him before the game, and he said that his team was young and hurt, and you know what, Tim, that's not a very good combination playing on the road in the Atlantic Coast Conference. Well, these guys are battlers. Denny Clemente in the game.
Miami is hurt. Anthony King lost for the season with a wrist injury, suffered December 3rd in that upset win over Georgia Tech. Miami's always caused Maryland problems with a three-guard scheme. They really aren't able to do that now. Guillermo Diaz and Robert Height are gone. Maryland Terrapins ranked 25th in the nation, ranked 24th in the RPI as you look at Gary Williams, head coach. Now in his 18th season with the Terrapins, won 367 games here and won a national championship along with 11 NCAA tournaments in the last 13 seasons. Terps force another turnover, leading by one. Strawberry takes it in. No foul called. Body's flying, and Miami comes up with it. And McClinton banks it in.
Miami is a team that does not mind getting out to run. They're playing that three-guard alignment you talked about, Tim, because Clemente has come in and Asbury has gone out.
Beckway steps on the line. Turnover for Maryland.
With a team like the Maryland Terrapins that likes to get up and down so much, you have to be able to defend in transition. And Strawberry at the end of the play fakes, goes to the basket. Now it's Collins coming over to help out with the block.
So they readjust in here. Strawberry on McClinton. The foul will be called on James Gist. His first, team second.
One of the things you cannot do against DJ Strawberry if you're McClinton is play passively. And McClinton certainly has not done that today. He has been in attack mode.
Collins goes out. Jimmy Graham comes in. Graham, a 6'8", 245-pound sophomore from Goldsboro, North Carolina. Officials tonight, Brian Kersey, Mike Wood, and Jamie Lucky. Miami dominating on the boards early. Six rebounds to Maryland's none. Inside to Graham, who just came in, and he banks it in.
Went nice job to get the ball down inside. Miami is not noted for their inside game, but Graham, a big kid, 6'8", about 240.
Jones, yes, that's for three. Keep in mind, he had 9 threes against Missouri, Kansas City. University of Missouri, Kansas City, that is. Clemente calls the play. Terrapins on the run. This is Vasquez. Doesn't have numbers and pulls it back out.
But boy, he can sure get the ball down the court quickly, Tim.
Yes, with a turnaround.
Yeah, I don't know that that's a particularly good shot by Maryland in that situation.
Terrapins just getting one shot. This would be goaltending.
But there's no movement on offense. It's basically one or two passes and a shot, and that gives Miami the opportunity to get out and run on the rebound.
Miami 10, Maryland 8, 15:37 to play in the first half.
Aaron, cow.
Cow.
Yes, sweetie, cow.
Cow.
Paul, where are the burgers?
For breakfast, try Chick-fil-A's tasty chicken biscuits, chicken minis, or breakfast burritos.
Paula Sela is a real Geico customer, not an actor. So to help tell her story, we hired that announcer guy from the movies.
When the storm hit, both our cars were totally underwater.
In a world where both of our cars were totally underwater,
we thought it would take forever to get some help.
But a new wind was about to blow.
With Geico, we had our check in 2 days.
Payback. This time, it's for real.
Geico. Real service, real savings.
The Ford F-150 Supercrew or the Toyota Tundra Double Cab. Ford's making a lot of claims about their truck. Here are the facts. Toyota Tundra Double Cab has more standard horsepower, payload capacity, and towing ability than the F-150 Supercrew, all for about $3,000 less. A full-size Toyota Tundra. Why settle for less F-150 when you can get more Tundra?
Get $4,000 cash back plus the Sport Package discount for a total savings of $6,000 on the Tundra Double Cab. Toyota, moving forward.
Back in College Park, Miami Hurricanes lead the Maryland Terrapins by 2 with 15:37 to play in the first half. Meanwhile, ACC action down in Atlanta. How about this, Dan? Georgia Tech and Duke tonight. And Georgia Tech with an upset win.
You know, playing on the road in the ACC, Duke going down to Georgia Tech, I don't know, despite the fact that Duke is ranked and Georgia Tech is unranked, that that's really that much of an upset. It's a very good Georgia Tech team and a Duke team that has a hard time putting as many points on the board as the Duke teams traditionally do.
Bottom line is Duke now 0-2 in the conference.
Yes.
Clemente off balance, not a good shot. Strawberry has it, he'll run with it. Jones, he's fouled.
I think it's important that Miami make sure they get good opportunities every time down the court. You want to play in transition. Frank Haith does not mind the up and down game. is guys need to make better decisions.
Well, Gary Williams has been upset in the early moments of this ball game because the Terps' biggest improvement this year has been on defense. And they average about 8 steals a game, but they've been out-rebounded and out-hustled here in the first few minutes of this one.
Well, if you look at the Maryland stats, one of the things that they do is they give up an awful lot of offensive rebounds.
Jones misses the second. Maryland Terrapin shooting just 1 of 6, other than Jones, who's 2 for 2 beyond the arc. Clemente penetrates, misses the layup. Graham is there with the rebound and taken away by Vasquez. Great hustle by the freshman. Wisely just kicks it back outside. Gary Williams tells him to set the offense. Knocked out by Miami. Well, our Chick-fil-A nugget of the game. Maryland defense ranks among the top 5 in all these categories. First in field goal and blocks. Fifth in steals, second in defensive rebounds.
Most important stat there, though, is number of points they give up. Not very many.
First in block shots as well. The Clinton shot is blocked. Second shot follow is blocked.
But what a great job to hustle down the court and get 2 of them. Graham now going to be called for travel. But, Tim, you were just talking about Maryland's ability on the defensive end. And when you can block shots like that, even when you're chasing, that wasn't – this is the guys coming from behind. Jones comes from behind and gets the first one. Hicks with the rebound, and now Osby gets the second one. So they're blocking shots even when they're chasing. That's very impressive.
And that's why they're first in the league in blocks.
Great Jones, block shot.
Jones' first miss beyond the arc tonight. He's 2 for 3.
And one thing Maryland has not been able to do is rebound those missed shot opportunities.
Nice drive by McClinton.
Miami drops back into the zone defense.
Strawberry will take it.
See, against the zone, you cannot simply settle for the outside shot.
McClinton on the line. That's for 2. Draws iron. Good save by Clemente.
Maryland trying to exert pressure, being urged on by Gary Williams.
McClinton halfway down, came back out.
McClinton, the local kid from Baltimore, you know he'd really like to get off a little bit.
Gist for 3. Are you kidding me? Rolls it in. And we're tied at 12. That's not the shot I think Gary Williams wants Gist to be taking.
Well, Gist actually now on the season a 60% three-point shooter, 3 out of 5. Maryland struggling a little bit from the field.
And they're being out-rebounded 15-3 by the Hurricanes. Knocked away by Vasquez. Taken back by Clemente.
That's a lot of missed shots in the first 7 and a half minutes of the game.
And Gist with another block. Three still on the shot clock. 12:21 to play in the first half. It looked like the players thought a timeout had been called.
A couple of substitutes in the game, and Miami needs to be aware of the time on the clock. Don't have time to do that.
Shot clock violation. Never got the shot off. Never recognized the fact that they had 3 on the shot clock. Frank Haith really upset.
Well, Frank Haith was telling them that there was only 3 seconds left on the clock. Of course, in the first half, his team is shooting at the basket opposite his bench. But boy, you have to look up at the clock. You know how much time's left.
You know what's been impressive about Maryland thus far this season is they've been limiting teams to 29 points in the first half. Miami now just 1 of their last 8. Let's see if Maryland can convert on their end.
Miami
switches back to the man-to-man. Strawberry with the drop step to follow. And here's Osby underneath. He takes it up strong. He has blocked again.
Boy, Osby, a powerfully looking, powerfully built guy. Oh, boy, Strawberry very nearly picking up foul number two right there.
Miami using a lot of the shot clock. It's down to 15. They're going to call this on Osby. Timeout on the floor with 11:27 to play in the first half. We are tied at 12.
If you're looking to ramp up your ride, get ready. Advance Auto Parts has a special order center just for you. Your one-of-a-kind, one-stop shop for everything you could ever want in parts and performance accessories. Everything from lift kits to cool custom accessories is ready for direct-to-your-door delivery or convenient in-store pickup. When you want the most complete selection of parts and accessories, the only place to go is the special order center in Advance Auto Parts.
We're ready in advance.
Take to use energy to make your home more efficient, to preserve our resources and the environment, to make sure the quality of life you enjoy is enjoyed by your children and their children, to lower your electric bill and say, yeah, I'm making a difference. What does it take? People, performance, excellence. To save money with programs like Home Energy Check, visit progress-energy.com/save.
Recently, Car and Driver held a head-to-head comparison. 600 car enthusiasts were asked to compare three cars in performance, handling, and styling. So who won? Camry? Accord? Actually, the all-wheel drive Ford Fusion came in first. Check it out yourself. Visit a Ford dealer or go to FusionChallenge.com. Now just sign and drive off with zero down, zero first month's payment, and zero due at signing. Lease a Ford Fusion for only $249 a month. Take the Fusion Challenge today.
More ACC basketball coming your way on Saturday. NC State and Wake Forest will go after it. That's Dan Bonner will be at that ball game to bring it to you on the Raycom Sports and Lincoln Financial Sports Network. And then later in the day at 2 o'clock, actually 2 p.m. game there as well, Virginia and Boston College. And I'll be in Boston with Mike Jaminski. Here in College Park, we're tied at 12. Miami and Maryland.
Boy, Miami now has missed 11 shots, and they have 8 offensive rebounds. Neither team shooting the ball very well, but Miami creating a lot more opportunities.
Almost halfway through the first half, we're tied at 12. Low scoring ball game. Clemente will penetrate and loses the handle and turns it over.
So when you have a team like Maryland and you can put as much pressure on an opponent as Maryland is doing, you can make up for a number like this. A lot of those, 8 of them coming on the offensive end for the Miami Hurricanes, but Maryland's defense really not permitting Miami to capitalize on those offensive rebounds.
7 turnovers for Miami.
So that, you know, 8 offensive rebounds but 7 turnovers, so that just sort of cancels it out.
Anthony Harris comes in the ballgame as Clemente gets a rest for Miami.
Miami has switched back and forth between the man-to-man and the zone. They're in the zone right now.
Eric Hayes in the ballgame for Maryland along with Paris Brown.
Maryland has been unable to get the ball inside this zone defense, settling for perimeter jump shots.
This is Brown on net.
That's a nice job. You fake, you get into the lane area, score the basket.
I like the way Hayes runs the Maryland offense at point. Reminds me a lot of Steve Blake. I actually thought the Terrapins were better when he started and Vasquez came off the bench to give him a spark. Penetration, another block. This is Asbury, has it blocked and knocked away. The ball touched the baseline, so it'll be Miami basketball.
Vasquez and Hayes, certainly different kinds of players in terms of their personality.
Vasquez and Hayes both in the ballgame now, roommates, freshmen. They'll be starting together next year, I'll guarantee you. Vasquez going with the shot. Put back is good by Osby.
No bucket. Back.
No bucket. And a foul on Osby.
Boy, Osby went flying in there. He's very upset. This has not been a very clean game. There's been a lot of contact. Osby clearly coming over the back of hits right there.
Tell you what, Osby's an enforcer, though. 6'8", 250 pounds, and as you said, he came flying in there. Miami had scored in the last 3:41.
They've had a couple of open looks, but the Maryland pressure really sort of, even on those open looks, forcing Miami to rush a little bit.
Oh, the turnover by Miami, that's eight.
Maryland, once again, doing a great job pressuring the basketball. It's hard for the guys with the ball to find open players when you're exerting that much pressure.
Miami, six straight possessions, six straight misses, eight turnovers. And they're still only down by two. Hayes from outside.
When you take the ball down the court, don't pass it to anybody, just shoot it. It's fine as long as the ball goes in the basket, but if you miss, particularly against the zone, nobody really in any sort of a position for an offensive rebound.
After Hayes missed, Gary Williams put his hands in his face. He's going to be doing that a lot with a couple of freshmen. Join the Mania, ACC fans. You could win up to $100,000 plus hundreds of other great prizes. To enter, all tells My Circle Mania sweepstakes, just text HOOPS to 844-353 or visit MyCircleMania.com. Vasquez. Brown penetrates. Running one-hander, air ball. Will Bowers fights for it. And last touch by Bowers, so it'll be Miami basketball.
Actually, Bowers was out of bounds when he last touched the ball. These guys are really going at one another. Osby loses the ball coming to Bowers. Fortunate he didn't get a foul called on him.
Officials look over there shaking their heads. This has to be one of those difficult games to officiate. Brian Kersey, Mike Wood, Jamie Lucky doing a nice job, but it's not a really crisp game. It's sloppy at this point.
The game is much easier to play and certainly much easier to officiate when the ball is going in the basket. And at this point, for neither team, is the ball going in the basket.
Miami's been scoreless the last 10 possessions.
It's amazing that they're only down 2 points.
I agree. Mike Jones will come back into the ballgame. Paris Brown will go out. Foul was on Bowers. It's also been a quiet crowd tonight at Comcast Center.
Maryland in man-to-man.
Oh boy. Reach around by a Beckway.
The last two fouls have been fouls by your big guys 40 feet from the basket. You know you're trying to apply pressure, but you have to really be smarter about it than that.
.823 to play in the first half. Harris looking for anybody to score. Go down low to Graham. Has that shot blocked by a Beckler.
But Maryland doing a great job blocking shots.
Hayes, Vasquez, looking for something to happen. Beckley looked, had a notion. Bowers to Jones. Yes.
Now that's the guy you want shooting the threes, just as well for Gary's blood pressure that a Beckley didn't shoot.
Jones, third tray of the night. It's an 8-0 Maryland run.
Nice pass.
Graham left alone. Graham again. And misses, and Bowers with a rebound.
The Terrapins just go flying at the basketball. Really put pressure on the shooter.
Jones feeling it. Seemed to lose that one, though, on the way up.
Right, he didn't really have a good grip on that one. Miami really desperate for a basket right here.
Asbury, good drive. Can't finish. Hicks gets the roll. And that ends a long drought. They went 6 minutes and 40 seconds without a bucket.
And yet they only trail by three. Miami, after the basket, drops back into the man-to-man defense.
You know, there are some teams that you just always have trouble with. Maryland always seems to struggle with Miami. Ebekwe is fouled. His foul is called on Hicks. Timeout on the floor. We'll be back.
You love our burgers, and that's just the beginning. Introducing our premium age prime sirloin, cut from the best of the best beef.
Prime is what a steak lover lives for.
Almost too tender for a knife, too juicy for words. And try our new fresh jumbo lump crab cake. All jumbo lump meat, nearly no cake. Uncompromising quality, incredible freshness. Yours always, Ruby Tuesday.
Nothing draws a neighborhood crowd together like the big game or the big race. And the best place to catch the action is right from your own living room. Food Lion is happy to help keep your home concession stand stocked all season with a fantastic variety of delicious foods at prices that will have you cheering. Food Lion, good neighbors, great prices.
The dream is still alive, someday it will come true. And this country, it belongs to folks like me and you. So let the voice of freedom sing out through this land. This is our country.
This is our truck. The 2007 Motor Trend Truck of the Year. The all-new Chevy Silverado.
You want the candy?
You can't have the candy. They call me the bus driver kid because I'm about to take you to school. Vader! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Man, I said this to everybody.
Hey. What are you guys looking at?
Nothing.
Catch My Circle Mania. Text HOOPS to 84353 for a chance to win $100,000.
Get ready to get the games you can't see on TV. Introducing ACCSelect.com, the new way to see your sport.
Maryland leading 17-14. Mike Jones, the reason. 10 points so far here, 3 of 5 from the field. Maryland just 3 of 17, the rest of the team. Tech, look at the women's scores. Virginia Tech winning easily over, or men rather, winning easily over UNC Greensboro. That's very interesting, Tim. As Ebekwe gets ready to shoot the free throws, Maryland is 4 for 8 shooting threes, but only 2 of 14 shooting from inside the three-point arc. Terrapins now 2 of 3 from the free throw line. There's Mike Jones, you mentioned. He's 3 of 5 from beyond the arc. All of his shot attempts have been from beyond the arc. And Kenny Ebekwe, one of 4 Maryland players averaging in double figures.
Ebekwe has now hit 49 of his 77 free throws this year. Maryland Terrapins leading 19-14, 6:43 to play first half. Hurricanes try to run. Collins, he's short with his jumper, and Bowers comes up with it. And this will be a foul on Collins. Now we get to the ACC women. Virginia Tech winning big over North Carolina Greensboro. Maryland Terrapins, number 1 in the nation, had an easy time tonight with Miami, 111-53. Coming off that big win over Michigan State. How about the ACC women? 1-2-3 nationally.
Well, of course, the ACC women very well represented in the NCAA tournament last year.
Mike Jones had it go down and came back out. Boy, that was an NBA three.
Well, I think it was more than that.
Vasquez will pump from beyond the arc. Don't want to fall in love with that shot.
It's just a sloppy game right now. This foul called on Wilt Bowers.
But one of the things that Miami has done well defensively is to keep Maryland away from the basket and to force them into perimeter shooting. And Maryland has not shot the ball well from the perimeter. They have made 4 3-point baskets, but sometimes if you're not really a great three-point shooting team, and Maryland is a team that while their percentage from three-point range is very good this year, their character is to take it inside first and then come outside. And when you're that kind of a team, sometimes you hit a couple of threes early and you change your character, and that's not good.
Collins hits the first. Vasquez and Bowers go out of the ball game. Gistin and Beckway back in the ball game along with Strawberry, Jones, and Hayes. Collins has his second one coming. He's just a 57% free throw shooter, but looked pretty good on those two.
Miami coaching staff really likes Collins' potential.
Miami's got to feel pretty good. They have not played well, have not shot well, and have turned the ball over, and they're only down three.
There they come up with it again.
Clemente gets away with a carry.
That's a high dribble. I don't know that that was really a carry. There's no rule that says you have to dribble the ball down by your ankle.
And a foul called on Gist. Maryland just looks out of sync. This broadcast is a copyrighted presentation. Any use of it without the express permission of Raycom, Lincoln Financial Sports, and the ACC is prohibited.
It's two fouls now on Gist. And the Terrapins big guys, each one of them has gotten a foul out here by our broadcast position, and that's not where you want your big guys getting fouls.
So Osby comes back in, Gist takes a rest. Harris at the line, he scored 61 of their 90 games at Miami. So he's not intimidated to be on the road, eighth all-time in assists.
This is a guy with a lot of experience for Miami, and he really has not played as well yet this year as they hoped he would play. Had 33 points against UMass was a big reason why they won that game.
Nice rebound by Osby. Hayes, cross-court pass to Jones. An offensive foul called on Jones.
Thus far, this has been a game without much rhythm. Guys playing very hard. It's tremendously intense. Strong defensive efforts, but the offense just hadn't caught up with it yet.
Three-quarter press by Maryland. Soft press. They drop back.
One advantage that Miami has in this situation is the crowd really has been out of this game.
Well, part of that is the Maryland students are still not in class. Osby gives it right back. Clemente, nice pass to Collins. And we're tied at 19.
Boy, nice battle by Miami.
Despite the fact that the Maryland students are not in school, good crowd here tonight, just about a sellout. Comcast Center, 17,950, another turnover. Back to Harris, good pass to Collins, and Miami leads. Gary Williams wants a timeout with 4:45 to play in the first half. So with timeout on the floor, as the teams discuss strategy, you should too. Get someone to talk with you, not at you. Talk to Chuck, Charles Schwab. What are they talking about, Dan? What do they have to do?
Well, I think what Gary Williams is telling his guys is while they have to play with great intensity on the defensive end, when they come up on the floor on offense, they just have to slow down a little bit. They're going one step too fast. They don't have to force things. They have the opportunity. If they can get an opportunity in transition, take it. But if not, pull it back out. I think Maryland has an advantage on the inside, and they haven't tested that advantage yet tonight.
But you've played in these games where it's just hard to get in rhythm, hard to get in sync.
There's no question about it. This is an Atlantic Coast Conference game between two pretty good defensive teams, and nobody gets any points for artistic value. The only thing that counts is whether you win.
Miami on a 7-0 run, and four of the seven have come off Maryland turnovers.
Maryland's problem has really not been on the defensive end. They just have not been very efficient on the offensive end.
Beckway again had a look, didn't take it. Osby down low. Good strong power move. Draws iron.
See, now that's exactly where Maryland wants to go with the ball. You get your ball, you get the ball, your big guy Osby. You'd like him to finish that one on the inside. That's a tough shot, though. Well defensive by Miami.
Terrapins jump out and trap, and Miami throws it away. Good job by Beckway and Vasquez on Harris. And the turnover by the Hurricanes.
Beckway was matched up against that young man right there, Keaton Copeland, walk-on, getting a start for Miami. Copeland's not really a three-point threat. He was in the corner of Beckway, left him, created the double team, and got the turnover.
11 turnovers now for Miami as you look at their run. Maryland in a little bit of a drought, trying to end that here. Doing a nice job on Jones. He started out beyond the arc, 3 for 4. They jumped him and they tightened things down.
Well, Strawberry still hasn't scored yet.
And Strawberry is fouled. Gary Williams spirit. Gary Williams said, "You're calling it down here. You're not calling it down there. We're in College Park, the Comcast Center." 3:37 to play in the first half, and Miami leads Maryland 21-19.
At the Gatorade Sports Science Institute, we test athletes in the lab. Because we know they'll be tested on the field. Gatorade, the most tested sports drink on the planet.
Somewhere between starting a business and growing one, you're going to need a bank. We'd like to be it. The small business advisors of RBC Centura. With more proactive advice, proven ideas, and dedicated service than you'd expect from a bank. RBC Centura. Let's do something giant.
If you're looking to ramp up your ride, get ready. Advance Auto Parts has a special order center just for you. Your one-of-a-kind, one-stop shop for everything you could ever want in parts and performance accessories. Everything from lift kits to cool custom accessories is ready for direct-to-your-door delivery or convenient in-store pickup. When you want the most complete selection of parts and accessories, the only place to go is the Special Order Center in Advance Auto Parts.
We're ready in advance.
Everything's getting faster. Sexier. And yet less expensive. So, why not cars? Say hello to the G6 sedan, G6 coupe, and G6 hardtop convertible. G6, one of the fastest growing brands in America. Pontiac, designed for action.
Well, it's been a sloppy first half here at College Park, but Miami leading Maryland 21-19 in a little bit of a surprise with 3:37 to play in the first half. Some of the scores, Georgia Tech beating Duke today. A little bit of a surprise there, Virginia Tech over North Carolina Greensboro.
Tim, one of the interesting things, I thought that Miami could only have success today if they shot the ball very well from three-point range, and so that Maryland's three-point defense would be very important. Miami hadn't made a three in this game yet. But they lead mainly because of their advantage on the boards. 11 offensive rebounds for the Hurricanes so far.
Vasquez takes the three, can't get it to go down, and again, a battle for the ball, and the Hurricanes come away with it.
That is rebound number 29 for the Miami Hurricanes. Terrapins have but 12.
Miami 8-8 overall, 1-1 in the Atlantic Coast Conference, having beaten Georgia Tech and losing their last game by 1 point to Wake Forest. This is for three. And Osby with a big rebound. He gives him a big body in there.
Well, he sure does.
Vasquez throws it away.
It's now 6 turnovers for the Terps.
And they're being dominated on the boards. Miami's season high rebounds is 43. They already have 29 here tonight.
Maryland continues to do a great job pressuring the ball.
Collins, jump hook, draws iron, takes it right back, scores.
There's another offensive rebound.
And Maryland has gone now scoreless in the last 4 minutes and 10 seconds. Some of the so-called experts, Dan, say Maryland's going to be a stock market team up and down because some of the youth that they have in key positions, as Osby is fouled. You know, folks, there's nothing like college basketball, and if you're celebrating the win, do it right. The way you celebrate sure says a lot about you and reflects on your school, so be responsible, take care of yourself and your friends. That's a message from Anheuser-Busch.
Tim, that may be true. Maryland, however, returns as much experience as just about anybody in the league. The difficulty that you have, though, when you play a team like Miami, they're a scrappy bunch. They have a lot of young players, too, so they're up and down. So if you catch them on a night when they're up, they can be a very good team.
Okay, watch Osby's free throw motion. It looks like he almost loses the ball before he shoots it. Osby, 60% free throw shooter, but with an unusual motion. Takes it away again. They just took it right out of the hands of the Beckway.
This is the kind of a game where you can't be out there waiting for the official to blow the whistle. You really have to tough it out. You've got to be very strong with the basketball.
McClinton for three, way outside.
Well, that was way outside. That was off the dribble. That was in the face of some pretty good defense. That's the first three-point basket made by Miami today. Gives them a six-point lead.
And right now, Maryland needs a leader. And Strawberry's 0 for 4, 0 points. He's usually their leader. And Jones is fouled from behind by Dews.
Now what Maryland needs is a basket. Jones has an opportunity to give him 2 points from the free throw line.
It's a 12-1 Miami run. I think this crowd is shell-shocked. Sounds like the library in here.
How would you know what the library around here sounds like?
That's a good point. Jones is keeping him in this ball game. He's got 11 points now. He's an 82% free throw shooter. And he misses the second. This is unbelievable. Harris picks up his dribble, gets it to Hicks. Still plenty of time on the shot clock at 15. Strawberry on McClinton. Down to Graham. Nice pass, and it's blocked by Gist. Correction to Beckwith. Out to Vasquez, beyond the arc.
Maryland just cannot make a perimeter jump shot with the exception of Mike Jones.
Ice cold.
That was a great opportunity. They played very well on the defensive end. Forced a difficult shot. A Beckway block as they come down and get the kind of a shot that they want in transition. Just can't get it to go down.
Well, it didn't take very long for ACC fans to get to know the newcomer Jack McClinton, who you're watching here tonight. The Miami transfer tied his career-high 30 points in a two-point loss to Northwestern in the ACC Big Ten Challenge. Since then, he's continued to be one of the dominant scorers in the league. He leads the league in three-pointers, shooting three and 48% from three-point range. Mike Jones is second in percentage, but boy, McClinton really made a difference.
30 friends and family of Jack McClinton in attendance tonight, and that's part of his group right there we mentioned from Baltimore. And McClinton, I think, has done a nice job under heavy pressure this evening. Maryland in the man-to-man.
Shot clock at 17, game clock at 32. We told you Maryland holds its opponents to 29 points a half We didn't know they would only shoot 21. McClinton with five on the shot clock. Back to Hicks, beyond the arc. And Bowers knocks it out of bounds. So with 15.8 left in the first half, shot clock off, Miami will have the ball.
Very frustrating for Maryland. An outstanding defensive effort, but your defense doesn't end until you get the ball. Frank Haith has to be happy that his team got that one. Gary Williams is a little frustrated. Will Bowers just not able to get his hands on it and pull the rebound down.
Still plenty of time. Stolen by Strawberry. Calls timeout. I'm not sure he had possession when he called it, but he got it.
Now you can't call timeout unless in the official's judgment you do have possession.
My point exactly. Take another look at it. Great hustle by Strawberry nonetheless.
Strawberry comes from under the basket, tips the ball away, but then loses his balance. You know, and the possession arrow, Tim, in that situation was pointed in the direction of Maryland. And so if he just lays on the ground and gets tied up, Maryland gets the ball anyway. I am just not a big fan of, unless it's the last, you know, couple of minutes of a game, a player calling that timeout to maintain possession. I think the timeout in that situation is more important to possession, particularly when the possession arrow is in the favor of the Maryland Terrapins.
And Dan, the bottom line is Maryland does not have to hurry here. They still have 12.3 seconds remaining in the half. Vasquez will bring it in. Jones has had the hot hand. He goes to Ibekwe. Back to Vasquez.
Jones has had the hot hand, but for the most part, the Terrapins have been limited to outside shots.
Vasquez has it blocked with 2.9.
Still have time. You don't have to just catch it and shoot it. Maryland, they catch it in time for a dribble or two. Not for a turnover, however.
And this is no good, even if it goes. Well, Miami closes the first half on a 12-2 run over the last 6:45, and they lead 26-21. Mike Jones with 11 points leads all scorers. A sloppy first half in a quiet Comcast Center. We'll be back. Park, the Comcast Center, Miami leading by five. But last night, how about Clemson? Off to its best start in school history. Only unbeaten team left in Division I. Vernon Hamilton with 21 points. Number 17, Clemson beat NC State 87-76. Rivers and Mays combined for 16 points for Clemson. So take a look at the Toyota ACC standings. Clemson right up top, 3-0. Then comes Boston College, Virginia Tech, North Carolina, Virginia still unbeaten. And then look at Duke with a loss tonight, 0-2 in the conference. It's been spectacular so far, but this game here tonight has not been indicative of ACC play. It's been sloppy. As a matter of fact, Collins and McClinton have combined for 19 points to lead Miami to a five-point lead. Take a look at some of the rankings now. We'll show you where the Atlantic Coast Conference stands. First, the women's top 25, and Maryland, North Carolina, and Duke hold down the top three spots. Maryland winning again tonight. Big, big over Miami, 111-53. So it's been dominated by Maryland ACC women. Here in the Comcast Center in College Park, Maryland, this one's a sloppy one. Maryland trailing Miami, 26-21. We'll be back with more after this.
You love our burgers, and that's just the beginning. Introducing our premium age prime sirloin, cut from the best of the best beef.
Prime is what a steak lover lives for.
Almost too tender for a knife, too juicy for words. And try our new fresh jumbo lump crab cake. All jumbo lump meat, nearly no cake. Uncompromising quality, incredible freshness. Yours always, Ruby Tuesday.
The road to the men's ACC basketball tournament is full of rivalries, potholes, even mud. So during the Chrysler Jeep Drive to the ACC Tournament Sweepstakes, we're giving away an all-new Chrysler Sebring and a Jeep Wrangler Unlimited to help two lucky grand prize winners navigate the roads, along with tournament tickets, accommodations, and an ACC gift bag. Enter today at participating Carolina Chrysler Jeep dealers or online at drivetotheacctournament.com. Because on the road to the ACC Tournament, the competition is fierce, but hopefully the traffic won't be.
This moment in ACC basketball history is presented by GEICO. Earlier this season against Duquesne, Boston College's Sean Williams recorded a triple-double. The 6'10 junior scored 19 points, pulled down 10 rebounds, and blocked 13 shots. It was the 22nd triple-double recorded in league history. Congratulations to Sean Williams for marking his moment in ACC basketball history, which has been presented by GEICO.
Welcome back inside the Comcast Center. Miami leading Maryland, but these have been some successful years. Gary Williams leading the Terps to 11 NCAA tournaments in the last 13 years, highlighted by that national championship, but a sloppy first half.
But, Tim, when the ball doesn't go in the basket, it tends to look sloppier than it is. And Maryland only shooting 20% from the field in the first half. One of the key things was the offensive rebounding by Miami. They missed a lot of shots, too. In fact, they missed 23 shots, but 13 times they got offensive rebounds. Tip in right there by Collins, who leads them in scoring with 10 points. Hicks gets an offensive rebound and scores. And Jack McClinton, we talked about him before the game. He has 9 points in the first half. Under heavy defensive pressure, he has been able to score. Mike Jones had 3 three-point baskets in the first half. James Gist had 1. The Terrapins scoring 4 baskets from beyond the three-point arc, but only 2 from inside the arc.
Take a look at the Chevrolet halftime statistics. And it's pretty much what you're talking about. I mean, the rebounds have just been dominated by the Hurricanes.
And interestingly enough, Maryland, a team that normally establishes the inside first and then goes to the outside, and goes to the outside pretty effectively, only 4 points inside scoring. Miami's done a nice job pushing them completely to the outside.
How do things change here in the second half?
Well, I think Maryland needs to, again, slow down a little bit on offense. They did a nice job creating defensive pressure, but they can't be in such a rush headed down the court on offense.
Okay, we're just about set here to start the second half. Comcast Center in College Park. We'll be back right after these messages. Stay with us.
You think you got game machine? All right, let's see what you got.
All day, baby.
Somewhere between starting a business and growing one, you're going to need a bank. We'd like to be it. The small business advisors of RBC Centura. With more proactive advice, proven ideas, and dedicated service than you'd expect from a bank. RBC Centura. Let's do something giant.
There are 5 ways to satisfy a jumbo shrimp craving, and only one place to do it. It's Jumbo Shrimp at Red Lobster, starting at $11.99. Choose your irresistible favorite, like hand-breaded jumbo crunch fried or mouth-watering jumbo scampi. Or try new Mediterranean jumbo shrimp pasta. Tender shrimp tossed in Italian herb butter with artichokes, fresh tomatoes, and sautéed onions. It's Jumbo Shrimp for a limited time, only at Red Lobster.
The road to the men's ACC basketball tournament is full of rivalries, potholes, even mud. So during the Chrysler Jeep Drive to the ACC Tournament Sweepstakes, we're giving away an all-new Chrysler Sebring and a Jeep Wrangler Unlimited to help 2 lucky grand prize winners navigate the roads, along with tournament tickets, accommodations, and an ACC gift bag. Enter today at participating Carolina Chrysler Jeep dealers or online at drivetotheacctournament.com. Because on the road to the ACC tournament, the competition is fierce, but hopefully the traffic won't be.
ACC basketball is brought to you by RBC Centura, by your Carolina Chrysler dealers, by Sonic Drive-In, by Charles Schwab, and by Red Lobster.
Well, here we go in the Comcast Center, and I'm telling you, the Maryland women here with Brenda Fries have everybody excited throughout the state of Maryland. The national champions, number 1 in the nation right now, undefeated. Big win again tonight against Miami, 111-53, just dominant
came in here the other night against a Michigan State team that had won five straight and dominated that game by more than 40 points. So they're excited about the Maryland women this year in college basketball. Meanwhile, the Maryland Terrapins trail Miami here 26-21 as we start the second half. Tim Brandt and Dan Bonner with you at the Comcast Center. Dan?
Tim, it's really hard as we get a look at the leading scorers for each of these two teams, and you see what they've done tonight. It's really hard if you're a basketball coach in this situation to take the optimistic view of things, because you're the Maryland Terrapins, and you've shot only 20% in the first half, and you're only down 5 points. That's pretty good.
Inside the go.
And that's nice where they need to go. Maryland in the first half was only 2 for 17. That's 11% shooting from inside the arc.
Well, Maryland getting one and done at most possessions in that first half. And it's a bigger ball club than Miami. You would think they would go down low and play the post. Here's Harris with the penetration. Kicks it out. And that's a three ball. So a good shot by Asbury as they start the second half. And it's 29-23 Miami. This is Jones. And the push by Abekwe. So that's two on Abekwe as we keep track of the personal fouls.
You know, under normal circumstances, you would say that's a pretty good shot for Mike Jones. But I think that early in the possession, playing against the zone defense, only one pass, and Jones shoots the ball. Maryland start out making four of their first seven three-pointers. They missed their last six, but the defense continues to be there. Strawberry stepping in and drawing the charge.
Asbury just completely out of control there, picks up the personal.
I think if you're Maryland, you want to make Miami play defense for a little bit longer.
Already, to me, Maryland looks a little bit more in control. Vasquez still leading the attack, running one-hander, but it just can't get it to go down. Still shooting poorly. Nice move by Harris. This will be an over the back by Keaton Copeland of Miami.
And this is the way the game has gone so far. A nice penetrating move by Harris, but that is a tough shot. It was a shot close to the basket, but a very difficult one. Nobody really in position for rebound.
Terps down six. Gist, Abekwe. Down to Gist. No foul called. Yes, sir. It's on Abekwe, and that is two quick ones.
That's a tough break for the Terrapins. Gist looked like he was open, but couldn't get the ball to the basket. Three fouls now on Abekwe.
With 18:15 to play, that's not a good thing for Maryland. Terrapins in a man-to-man. Shot clock at 12. McClint, wild shot. Abekwe is fouled from behind. This is going to be on Copeland, so Copeland picks up two quick ones. Wait, he has three personals.
A lot of fouls early here in the second half. We played barely more than 2 minutes. A lot of fouls. This is a poor shot by McClint, just way outside. And again, that was one of those shots where the defense didn't really make the opponent play defense very long. You got the ball and heaved it to the basket. It's tough to rebound the ball offensively in that situation.
We are going to get the 50 points tonight, aren't we, partner?
Well, they've already scored 52.
Nice play by Gist with the left-handed jump hook.
See, each of Maryland's baskets in the second half, close range. I think that's where Maryland has an advantage on the inside.
Asbury falling away, draws iron. Beckway with a rebound. Here come the Terps.
That's a great defensive effort by Mike Jones.
And Gist is fouled.
That's really a break for Maryland because that was a poor pass by Strawberry.
This is going to be on Collins.
You know, if that's three fouls now on Collins, if you're Strawberry, you're going to pass that ball into Gist in that transition situation. You got to throw that ball a little more mustard on it than that.
Jimmy Graham just coming out of the locker room. Got got his warm-up on. Doesn't look really happy to be out here.
He's got his hands in his pocket like he's cold. Maybe he's suffering from the flu or something.
Ibekwe down the lane. Kogan comes up with a force by Ibekwe. He had like an 8-foot shot and tried to make it a 3-foot shot and ended up having a block. Well, Maryland had the advantage there, and Vasquez just let him save the ball. So immediately, Hayes comes off the bench. Gary Williams upset with Vasquez just now. Hicks is fouled, and that's four on Ibekwe. Here's a look at Graham, who just came out of the locker room. And you're right, he doesn't look well.
Graham actually played 9 minutes in the first half, had 5 rebounds, 3 of them offensive rebounds, scored a couple of points.
And the report we get from the Miami bench is that he is not sick. Hicks at the line for Miami. Hicks only a 47% free throw shooter. So Hayes comes in, Bowers comes in, Ibekwe goes out with 4 personals, and Vasquez, who Gary's upset with right now, will take a seat as well. Makes the second one. Miami by 5.
Each team looking for some rhythm on offense, but the defense really making that difficult, and there Hicks picks up the foul against Jones. Good attack by Maryland against the Miami pressure. Not a lot of wasted motion in this effort by Maryland. Ball moves quickly up the court via the pass. Hicks is not in good position and fouls Jones on the way up. Jones, an excellent free throw shooter, going 2 of 4 tonight.
82% for the season. And makes the first. So Hicks made 1 of 2 at Miami's end. We'll see what Jones does at this end. Terrapins close within 4. Jones trying to make it a 1-possession game. And he does. Jones now with 13 points. Terrapins chasing defensively. Harris will fire for 3. Ball still loose. And Jones comes up with it.
Well, he got that in the midst of 3 green shirts.
Bowers. Yes! 1-point game, and all of a sudden, the Comcast Center comes alive.
Game's a lot easier when the ball starts going in the basket a little bit.
Copeland penetrates on Bowers. Oh, are you kidding me? Just threw it up and it went in. Inside to Bowers. And Hayes will reset the offense.
Strawberry hadn't scored in this game yet.
Hayes, to me, is the only one who doesn't look flustered right now. Yes. For 3.
The second of the game.
And it gives Maryland a tie for the first time in what has been about 12 minutes.
That is a deep 3 right there.
Terrapins run with it. Strawberry penetrates and is fouled. And it's on McClinton.
That was a much better job that time by Strawberry. One of the problems that Maryland has had thus far in this game, particularly the first half, is decision-making in transition. But that was a good one right there.
Frank Haith can feel the momentum changing. What's a timeout?
Welcome to my casa. It's your boy, BK. This here's my foyer. This is my game room. This right here is my new suede couch. To the pool, baby! These are my ladies. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Hey, man, who are you?
Steve.
You part of the crew?
No, I'm just here for the Bud Light.
Who gave you that? Wednesday, did you give him that?
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
Yeah, and this is where I spend most of my... Man, put down my papaya!
So we had this sudden panic. We've got investments all over. You name it, we've invested in it. What does it all add up to? I mean, realizing after, 25 years, that you don't even know what your investment picture actually looks like. That's a midlife crisis.
Nothing draws a neighborhood crowd together like the big game or the big race. And the best place to catch the action is right from your own living room. Food Lion is happy to help keep your home concession stand stocked all season with a fantastic variety of delicious foods at prices that will have you cheering. Food Lion, good neighbors, great prices.
You want the candy? You can't have the candy. They call me the bus driver kid because I'm about to take you to school. Vader! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Man, I send this to everybody.
Hey!
What are you guys looking at?
Nothing.
Catch My Circle Mania. Text HOOPS to 84353 for a chance to win $100,000.
Back inside the Comcast Center where we are tied at 32.
And one of the interesting things for Maryland, they shot the ball very poorly in the first half, only 20% thus far, 4 of 8 overall in the second half. But this man right here, DJ Strawberry, the Terrapins' leading scorer coming into the game, has not yet scored a point. He'll go to the free throw line for a couple of shots. He is a 72% free throw shooter on the year.
Still has his doubt. So Maryland has scored on 5 of its last 6 possessions. And Strawberry has now hit 56 of his 79 free throws, and he misses them both.
Oh, and misses both of them.
He is frustrated, just shaking his head, as is Gary Williams. Boy, if Miami's going to get him, this is a night. Because Maryland just not short. Kick it out. This is beyond the arc.
And one of the things that you can see already here in the second half is Maryland doing a much better job on the defensive boards. Miami has no offensive rebounds in this half. Maryland has 5 defensive rebounds. Miami limited to that outside shot. Asbury, who made one a little earlier, misses there. And that's Hicks. I think that was Hicks again.
It was Hicks, definitely Hicks.
And the foul problem is now starting to add up for Frank Hayes' Miami Hurricanes.
That's 3 on Hicks. Guess at the line. Mike Wood talking to him, make sure his head is clear. Officials tonight, Brian Kersey, Mike Wood, and Jamie Lucky.
Fabio Noss coming in the game for Miami.
And Gist misses the free throw.
Boy, that was a front end of a 1-1, and we've still got 14 and a half minutes left in the game. Maryland getting to that bonus situation very early.
You said at the beginning of the broadcast in the ACC, you have to win at home, and Clemente gives Miami the 2-point lead.
This is a night where Maryland's offense just has not been there, and so they have to keep up the defensive pressure to try to create some easier opportunity.
Mike Jones to Hayes. Down on the baseline, kicks it back out. Strawberry. And a foul. Foul will be, I believe, on Copeland.
Yeah, that was very good ball movement by Maryland. The penetration, they got cut off. They pass it out to the open man.
4 on Copeland.
Well, now Maryland has to take advantage from the free throw line.
And even though Maryland's playing poorly, Dan, and they aren't in that offensive flow, things now starting to go their way as Miami starts to get into some serious foul trouble here. That is 5 free throws they've missed in a row. Strawberry gets the rebound.
That's 2 front and the 1s and 1-1 in succession.
Hayes for 3. Big bucket by the freshman.
Hayes first points of the game.
I said it reminds a lot of people of Blake. Blake his freshman year, very rarely shot, but when he did, it was usually a big bucket. See if Miami can answer. They've been playing well. This is Clemente. McClinton.
Boy, that was
solid
defense.
With the rebound. And Clemente out hustles him for the ball.
Right. Strawberry just didn't handle the outlet pass. That was a good outlet pass by Bauer. Strawberry missed it. Clemente was able to run it down.
Strawberry really struggling in every phase of the game tonight.
Well, not defensively. He has done a nice job against McClinton. He gets called for a foul right there. That is a two-shot foul. McClinton was not behind the line.
These are like money in the bank, though. McClinton has hit 63 of his 69 free throws.
Points have been so hard to come by for each team in this game. You really have to take advantage when you get an opportunity. And, you know, the one place in this game where there's not guys flying at you in your face is from the free throw line.
Look at those things. Those babies should be illegal.
I'll tell you what, if you're a free throw shooter with any kind of focus at all, you don't even see that.
They're making me sick.
Close your eyes.
That's how I've been doing the game. Miami by one. Inside to Strawberry. Back to Vasquez.
Miami has done a nice job in this zone defense.
They've been sagging off Hayes. If they can swing it to Hayes, almost throw it away. Shot clock at five. Vasquez from way outside. That's not the shot that Gary Williams wanted.
No, they didn't attack very effectively that time. The ball never really went inside.
And Miami, another rebound, doing a great job on the boards. Canes by one.
Adams stays in the man-to-man.
Back outside. Nash with the drive, has it blocked and a foul. .11:46 to play. Timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well in College Park.
If you're looking to ramp up your ride, get ready. Advance Auto Parts has a special order center just for you. You're a one-of-a-kind, one-stop shop for everything you could ever want in parts and performance accessories. Everything from lift kits to cool custom accessories is ready for direct-to-your-door delivery or convenient in-store pickup. When you want the most complete selection of parts and accessories, the only place to go is the Special Order Center in Advance Auto Parts.
We're ready in advance.
How could it be offensive if it's true?
Okay, first of all, I'm not 100% in love with your tone right now.
Tone aside, historically, you guys have struggled to adapt.
Yeah, right. Walking upright, discovering fire, inventing the wheel, laying the foundation for all mankind. You're right. Good point. Sorry we couldn't get that to you sooner.
Connie, your reaction?
Sounds like someone woke up on the wrong side of the rock.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
I really like this breakfast bistro sandwich.
Oh,
this bacon is great.
Well, you know, in Italy, bacon is called pancetta.
How do you know that?
As a guy, I pretty much know everything there is to know about bacon. It's encoded into our DNA at birth.
I have some things encoded on my DNA.
Oh, yeah?
Like I'm able to sense when you're just full of it.
Bacon Breakfast Bistro Sandwich, only at Sonic. Bacon, eggs, and cheese on toasted ciabatta bread. Try one with the cranberry juice or any other juice, because Sonic is your ultimate drink stop.
The road to the men's ACC basketball tournament is full of rivalries, potholes, even mud. So during the Chrysler Jeep Drive to the ACC Tournament Sweepstakes, we're giving away an all-new Chrysler Sebring and a Jeep Wrangler Unlimited to help two lucky grand prize winners navigate the roads, along with tournament tickets, accommodations, and an ACC gift bag. Enter today at participating Carolina Chrysler Jeep dealers or online at drivetotheacctournament.com. Because on the road to the ACC Tournament, the competition is fierce, but hopefully the traffic won't be.
We have a doubleheader coming up Saturday starting at noon. Our first game comes from Tobacco Road, where young NC State travels to Winston-Salem to take on Kyle Visser in Wake Forest. Then at 2 o'clock, Sean Singletary leads Virginia to Boston College, where Jared Dudley and Sean Marshall will be waiting. More basketball on Raycom and Lincoln Financial Sports 25th anniversary of bringing you ACC Hoops. Check your local listings for the game in your area. Pass at the line for Miami. And he misses the first. Fabio Nas, 6'11", 202-pound junior.
Only his third free throw attempt of the year. There's Hicks back in the ball game as Copeland goes out.
From Fort Smith, Arkansas, by way of Brazil. This is the second. Guess with the rebound.
22, Raymond Hicks returns for Keaton Copeland.
Miami stays in that zone defense.
Vasquez, Strawberry, the double him. Clemente sagging off Hayes. This is Strawberry from beyond the arc. Not tonight. Bowers! And a jump ball possession arrow belongs to Miami.
Has better ball movement by Maryland. They missed the shot, but they forced the Miami zone defense to move. So they got in a situation where they very nearly got an offensive rebound. I think the first tie-up in there was between Gist and Bowers.
Terrapins again apply that soft pressure. Now they double out on Clemente.
They've done a nice job forcing Miami out of any sort of offensive pattern that Miami wants to run.
Still in a man-to-man. Oh, good penetration. And another block by Gist.
To the chest of the defensive player. That's an automatic call. So it's four fouls now on Bowers, four fouls on Ebekwe.
So both teams now with foul problems. We'll keep an eye on that with 10:30 to play.
Also returning 23, Mike Jones.
Oh, nice play. Strong move to the bucket by Asbury. And
Brian Asbury.
High backward shot, and it's a 38-35 lead by Miami.
Well, Maryland's problems continue to be on the offensive end.
Another rebound by the Hurricanes.
Maryland just not able to get very many offensive rebounds.
And they give up a layup at the other end. Gary Wynn's going to need a timeout.
A little spurt by Miami, and in this game, that's huge.
It is huge. 5-point lead, 9:55 to play.
Oh, give me the dude. Out of hand.
You wish.
I hope it's all fizzy. We're good.
Somewhere between starting a business and growing one, you're going to need a bank. We'd like to be it. The Small Business Advisors of RBC Centura. With more proactive advice, proven ideas, and dedicated service than you'd expect from a bank, RBC Centura, let's do something giant.
There are five ways to satisfy a jumbo shrimp craving, and only one place to do it. It's Jumbo Shrimp at Red Lobster, starting at $11.99. Choose your irresistible favorite, like hand-breaded jumbo crunch fry or mouth-watering jumbo scampi. Or try new Mediterranean jumbo shrimp pasta. Tender shrimp tossed in Italian herb butter with artichokes, fresh tomatoes, and sautéed onions. It's Jumbo Shrimp for a limited time, only at Red Lobster.
The road to the men's ACC basketball tournament is full of rivalries, potholes, even mud. So during the Chrysler Jeep drive to the ACC tournament sweepstakes, we're giving away an all-new Chrysler Sebring and a Jeep Wrangler Unlimited to help two lucky grand prize winners navigate the roads, along with tournament tickets, accommodations, and an ACC gift bag.
Enter today at participating Carolina Chrysler Jeep dealers or online at drivetotheacctournament.com. Because on the road to the ACC tournament, the competition is fierce, but hopefully the traffic won't be.
Get ready to get the games you can't see on TV. Introducing ACCSelect.com, the new way to see your sport.
Big ball game for Jack McClinton, and these are some of his fans. He plays for Miami, but he is right up the road in Baltimore, Maryland, and 30 tickets he had to get for this ball game. They all came down from Baltimore.
McClinton with 11 points on the night to lead Miami in scoring.
Getting down to crunch time here now, under 10 minutes to play. We'll see if Maryland can respond. Miami doing a nice job on fast break points and on rebounds. This is Osby, backs his way down.
Strong move. What a powerful move that was. Asbury, 6'7", 214, just no match for the 250-pound Osby inside.
Three-point game. Strawberry almost has the steal. But then he gets it back, and they reset.
Boy, Clemente hearing from Frank Haith over there. That was a lazy pass back to Harris, and Strawberry almost got it.
Shot clock down to 10. Hicks. Harris with the penetration, a running one-hander. Lost out of bounds by Maryland. And a new 35.
Maryland really struggled to score inside the three-point arc in the first half. Much better luck here in the second half, and that is just what you call a power move in there. There's no way Asbury Collins can handle him down inside if he gets that close.
Boy, McClinton had a look, pulled it back, thought better of it, with Strawberry right in front of him.
Strawberry 6'5", and it made it difficult to shoot over top of it.
Gets Strawberry in the air. This is beyond the arc, and it's short. Terps have a 2-on-1. Jones has it taken away from behind him.
Jones not really knowing where the defender was. What a play by Strawberry. My goodness. That saves a bucket for Maryland.
This is unbelievable.
That's just a poor pass by Gist. The defense has been dominant in this game. Mike Jones just not paying any attention, and then the steal. This looks like an easy basket, but Strawberry in to block the shot.
Maryland with 13 turnovers and only 12 field goals. It's almost like somebody put something in their pregame meal.
I think the guys in the green shirts have a lot to do with it.
They sure do. They've been hustling, playing hard. It's a dangerous ball club coming off that one-point loss to Wake Forest. They beat Georgia Tech. And a walk.
See, McClinton now really has to stay under control, trying to do a little too much right now.
7:52 to play. It's been an emotional ball game. Terrapins a little bit out of sync, but Miami doing everything they can to get a win on the road.
Just here for the Bud Light. Who's Ben?
Johnny!
Refreshingly smooth Bud Light. Always worth it.
Who's Todd Schischler?
Nothing draws a neighborhood crowd together like the big game or the big race. And the best place to catch the action is right from your own living room. Food Lion is happy to help keep your home concession stand stocked all season with a fantastic variety of delicious foods at prices that will have you cheering. Food Lion, good neighbors, great prices.
The dream is still alive. Someday it will come true. And this country, it belongs to folks like me and you. So let the voice of freedom sing out through this land. This is our.
Silverado.
Give me the rock. You want the candy?
You can't have the candy. They call me the bus driver kid because I'm about to take you to school. Vega! Oh!
Man, I said this to everybody.
Hey!
What are you guys looking at?
Nothing.
Catch My Circle Mania. Text HOOPS to 84353 for a chance to win $100,000.
Well, the Maryland Terrapins 11-0 here at home this year, but Miami leads the all-time series 6-5, including a split of the season series last season. And with 7:52 left to play, they lead the Terrapins 40-37. Maryland with the basketball. See if the Terrapins can find some sort of rhythm. Inside to Osby. And again, a strong power move, but he has it blocked. Hits it back and still won't go down. Great job on the board tonight by the Canes.
It's just been that kind of night for Maryland. That was a point-blank range attempt. And you're right, Miami battles and battles and comes out of there with the rebound.
They've out-hustled Maryland tonight. There's another three ball. And it's 43-37, and Maryland is in trouble.
That's James Dews. That's a young man that really doesn't play that much for Miami. He's played in all 16 games, hadn't started any, only about 12 minutes a game, but he has really done a nice job this evening.
Take a look at our Jeep game summary. It looks like this. 43-37, you look at the rebounds, dominated by Miami. Fast break points, 12-2. Points in the paint, 26-12. And right now, Miami on a 9-2 run.
Maryland back to the line for the 1-1 opportunity. They've missed two front ends of the 1-1 is in this half.
Every free throw seems to be an adventure for the Terps tonight.
The Terrapins really have to dig in right now. They have to continue to maintain their intensity on the defensive end, and they have to overcome the frustrations on the offensive end. Still lots of time left in this game.
Miami's done a great job tonight of frustrating the Maryland Terrapins.
You have to say that Miami certainly hasn't wilted. Maryland has applied very good pressure the entire evening. And Miami has turned it over some, but they've been tough enough. When you play a team like Maryland, you are going to have some turnovers. It's important how you recover, and Miami thus far has recovered, showed a lot of resilience tonight.
And the Canes have done a great job shortening the game, melting the clock, using all of the shot clock, which is now down to 5. Here's McClinton with the turnover.
Have to give Maryland a lot of credit right there, Tim. Miami is running the clock down. They're making the Terrapins play defense, but the Terrapins continue to be aggressive on the defensive end. Clinton comes out of the game. Frank Hayes over there encouraging his guys.
Only the third turnover by the Hurricanes this half. Down to Strawberry, who's not even looking for a shot now. Good strong power move. It will not go down. Ebekwe will go to the line.
No, you're right about Strawberry, Tim. He's 0 for 5 in the game. And interestingly enough, Gravis Vasquez 1 for 9. So two key perimeter players for Maryland thus far have combined for 1 for 14 from the field.
Hicks, meanwhile, picks up his fourth personal as Ebekwe at the line. He's only a 62% free throw shooter. And he makes the first. Got so quiet in here, you heard the one Miami fan yell, "Miss it." Ebekwe makes them both.
So Terrapins clawing back in.
43-41 Miami. And again, they bring it out. Clemente wants to use as much of the shot clock as he can. Good job by the Canes. Shot clock at 10. Osby with the rebound and loses it out of bounds. By himself and lost it out of bounds. Osby will go out of the game
and Will Bowers will come in.
Well, he lost it out of bounds because he was really trying hard to block out the Miami player down there. I think that was Copeland he was battling against. So you got to give some credit to Miami. They're battling on the offensive boards.
And a new 35. Clemente penetrates, running one-hander. Good rebound by Jones. Terps have a two-on-one. No foul called. Ball's still loose. And the foul's going to be called on Bowers.
Bowers just fouled out of the game.
Gary Williams is furious. Furious.
He thinks that Vasquez got fouled going to the basket. And some players ran in front of it, so I didn't really see what happened. But Vasquez appeared to have a pretty decent opportunity for a layup, and that layup was nowhere close.
Gary's got to be careful that he doesn't get a technical here, but he is furious. Terps down two with 5.5 to play.
I don't know that he is upset about the call against Bowers. Bowers clearly committed a foul. You're not allowed to jump in there on top of a guy.
Vasquez actually looked
Vasquez
like
lost the
down.
Ball going up.
And Strawberry goes down. And here's the foul on Bowers.
See, Bowers comes in over the back. That's a point of emphasis this year. The guys just can't dive in on top of the other guy going for a loose ball.
Gary Williams now tells Vasquez to set the offense.
Vasquez now 1-for-10 shooting the ball.
See if that emotion gets a tear up.
My goodness! That's amazing.
Jones for three. Not even close. Ball still loose. Be careful here. Game's getting physical.
Ball inside just slid out of Abekwe's hands. He missed a point-blank range shot, then he missed a tip, but comes up with an offensive rebound. Very frustrating evening for Maryland, but they continue to battle out there.
Gary Williams still hot about the no call at the other end and the foul on Bowers.
Frank Haith now trying to find out what's going on. I just think that Frank is trying to make sure that Gary doesn't hog the stage with the officials.
Frank just being very cool at the other end. And it gets quiet again for Abekwe. There's the free throw.
We saw Abekwe only a 62% free throw shooter on the year, now 5-for-5. And in a game where every point has been very, very difficult to score, get him from the free throw line, it's really a benefit.
Has a chance to tie the game here. And he does. It's a 6-0 Maryland run, all six on free throws. This game has had six ties, six lead changes, and it's knotted at 43. Good penetration by Harris. He can't finish. Terrapins keep it alive, but now it's all Hurricanes underneath. And Copeland pulls it. Copeland off balance, can't get it to go down. A whistle and a foul, and this is going to be called on Gist. That's three on Gist.
You know, the execution in this game isn't a thing of beauty, but you certainly can't fault the effort by either team. My goodness, are these guys going at it. Well, that's a nice play by Gist to prevent an easy basket. Then Gist just pushes Asbury out of the way.
Asbury makes the first free throw to give Miami a one-point lead. He's got one more coming. 45-43 Canes. Fun ball game. Different. Gist. Boy, they've missed some.
They've missed some
close range shots.
got to be careful. I think this is one of those games where the officials can understand the frustration of both of the coaches. Challenge for Maryland now is to maintain their defensive intensity.
Five on the shot clock, Copeland. And the finish inside, nicely done by Collins.
Well, again, a response by Miami. Maryland ties the game with that 6-0 run that you mentioned, Jim, but Miami then scores four in a row.
Timeout on the floor as the teams discuss strategy. You should, too. Get someone to talk with you, not at you. Talk to Chuck, Charles Schwab. What are they talking about here, Dan?
Well, I think in the Miami huddle, what Frank Hayes is trying to make sure his guys do is run that time off the clock. They've been doing a nice job making Maryland play defense, and the longer Miami possesses the ball, the less damage Maryland can do on the offensive end. But you want to be careful with that. It's very hard to run the clock down and get a shot at the end.
Well, we're down to crunch time now, the last 3:50 to play, 47-43 Miami. And there aren't a lot of opportunities.
Well, and on the defensive end, Frank Hayes wants to make sure that his guys continue to play with the intensity that they've demonstrated all night long. This zone defense has frustrated Maryland.
Carrapin's not in a hurry. Vasquez
man-to-man for Miami.
Looks at the change in the defense, gets it to Jones. Jones traveling, not getting it. Called for a travel, turnover for the Terrapins. 3:41 to play. Time out. We'll be back.
There's much you don't see. The path that led to the goal. The support of others. And the careful way everything's choreographed to create an effortless end. Fueled by 150 years of teamwork between alumni, students, faculty, and staff, the University of Maryland is now a leading public research university. And together, there's so much more we can do. The University of Maryland. Fear the turtle.
Plus, their guard play is so much stronger. They can basically go nine people deep and not lose anything. You know?
No. And the other guys are, like, starting maybe six-man?
Right.
Maybe six-man.
Right. Rejected! Don't you bring that weak tot action! You go strong to your mouth or you don't go at all!
Coney and Tots. Satisfy your game day craving with an extra-long chili cheese Coney and Tots. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
The Ford F-150 Supercrew or the Toyota Tundra Double Cab. Ford's making a lot of claims about their truck. Here are the facts. Toyota Tundra Double Cab has more standard horsepower, payload capacity, and towing ability than the F-150 Supercrew, all for about $3,000 less. The full-size Toyota Tundra. Why settle for less F-150 when you can get more Tundra?
Get $4,000 cash back plus the Sport Package discount for a total savings of $6,000 on the Tundra Double Cab. Toyota, moving forward.
Back inside Comcast Center, the crowd trying to get the Maryland Terrapins to go, but it looks like Miami's trying to steal this one, leading 47-43 with 3:41 to play. Hurricanes have hustled this entire ball game.
You know, they're only shooting 30% for the game, Tim. Maryland, which made five of their first 10 shots in this half, Tim, is one for their last 11.
Wow. And Miami doing a nice job of using as much of the clock as they can to shorten the game here on the road. Shot clock now at 10. Copeland left alone beyond the arc. And another rebound for Miami. Gist pulls it down. And calls timeout.
That's Maryland's last timeout.
And once again, he calls a timeout in a situation where the possession arrow was in the favor of Maryland.
Well, Red Lobster presents the nothing but net shot of the game. I'm guessing it's Miami. That's Collins.
Wow, this was the last play here where this is shot clock's running down and Copeland misses it, but the defense all went to Copeland's shot and trying to block it, and Collins was right there to tip it in.
So the Terrapins out of timeouts with 3:04 to play in the ballgame. That could be critical down the stretch.
And two of the timeouts that they called, Tim, where they called a timeout so there wouldn't be a held ball, and they had the possession arrow when they called it. See, Miami with three 30-second timeouts and their one full timeout left.
Maryland has four players who average in double figures, but tonight, boy, they have been struggling, and Strawberry has led the parade. Just cannot buy a bucket.
Strawberry still hasn't scored. 0 for 6 from the field, 0 for 2 from the free throw line. To his credit, however, he has done an outstanding job defensively. How about Dwayne Collins from Miami, though? 12 points and 11 rebounds. Showed you him tipping that last shot in. Maryland still has plenty of time here.
Miami. These are the Terrapins with the ball. Down low they go. Gist with the turnaround. How many times have we seen that today? Maryland scoreless over the last 2:20. This will be Terrapins' ball. Our Pepsi players of the game. Wayne Collins, Mike Jones. You just mentioned Collins. Jones with the 15 points. Strawberry off balance, and he's fouled. This foul will be called on Keaton Copeland.
I think that's five on him.
And it is. So he's DQ'd.
And each team will go to their respective benches. The coach has 30 seconds to make a substitution after the official notifies the score. After the score tells the official that the player has five fouls and the official notifies the head coach.
You know, Miami has a losing record against ranked teams and since the mid-90s. And as Frank Haith builds this program, that's one of the things he wants to change. They've beaten a ranked team in 11 of the last 12 seasons, though, so they are dangerous. And here they've got the 25th-ranked Maryland Terrapins on the ropes. Maryland actually ranked 24th in the RPI. EJ Strawberry at the line. He's wondering if there's a lid on the basket. Finally has a point tonight. So he cuts it to a three-point game and has another one coming. And he makes them both. So DJ Strawberry with his first 2 points. He averages 16 points, 5 rebounds a game. And Miami takes a timeout.
You know, this, you look at the Maryland statistics. James Gist shooting 3 for 10, and Beckway 1 for 5. Strawberry now, he's 0 for 6. He finally made a free throw, so he's 2 for 4 from the line. Tim, you pointed it out. Maryland, particularly in the second half, has gotten the ball inside to Gist, to a Beckway, to Bambale Osby at point blank range, and they haven't been able to convert. It's got to be very frustrating.
It's going to be this kind of year in the ACC with Clemson, the only unbeaten Division I team left in the country. Clemson 3-0 with that win last night.
And Clemson will be in here on Saturday, so it doesn't get any easier for the Maryland Terrapins.
17-0 overall for the Tigers, 3-0 in the conference. Two-point game, 2:45 to go. Here we go now.
Mike Wood trying to get the photographers back along the baseline. Asbury's allowed to run, and he does.
Terrapins now pick up the pressure full court. Harris gets it across the timeline.
That's a pretty tough play by Clemente. There was some contact there, but he wasn't waiting for the whistle.
This is a three ball. Oh, my gracious. And the putback by Collins, and no foul on the takedown.
Well, the takedown occurred after Obekwe lost the basketball. That was a ball that Obekwe had in his hands and couldn't control.
Gotta love the hustle of the Hurricanes. DJ Strawberry draws iron. Gist.
We still missed it.
But he'll go to the line to shoot two. Take a look at what happened down the other end.
Now, these teams continue to battle one another on the boards in Miami. 13 offensive rebounds in the first half. They haven't assembled those kind of numbers in the second half. But they're really working at it. I think Collins has now fouled out of the game.
So Collins now out of the ball game, along with Copeland.
Watch as Obekwe goes up, he grabs the ball. He just lost control of it.
That's a great, great follow by Collins. Maryland has missed 13 of its last 14 shots.
And again, they haven't been taking threes all those times. They've had some shots that are pretty close to the basket, shots that they would normally make.
So Gist goes to the line. He's the 75% free throw shooter. He's had five double-doubles this year, four in the last six games, and he makes that shot. Gist has 9 points, eight rebounds. Make it 10.
Terrapins have to dig in on defense, but when they get the ball back on offense, I think with the small lineup that Miami is forced to play due to guys fouling out, going inside to Gist would be a good option for the Terrapins, but first, they have to get a stop.
Under 2 minutes to play. Harris penetrates and banks it in.
You know, we talked before the game about how Harris really had to play well tonight.
Vasquez for three. Game slipping away from the Maryland Terrapins, and Miami holding on.
And Harris has done a nice job handling the ball. He's done a nice job controlling the tempo of the game, and he made a big basket right there.
And a foul on Vasquez. Vasquez just 1 for 11 from the field.
Harris will go to the line where he is a 71% free throw shooter.
Harris had that career high 33 points against Massachusetts. He's a senior out of Chicago, Illinois, one of the ACC's assist leaders. Guy averages almost four assists a game, 282 for his career. Knocks it down.
Every time in this second half that the Maryland Terrapins have made a run at Miami, the Hurricanes have responded. And they have responded despite the fact that a couple of their starters have fouled out of the game.
How about this? Maryland has not hit a field goal in the last 8 minutes and 16 seconds. Only one field goal in the last 12 and a half minutes. And Harris makes them both. Terrapins with no timeouts left. And 1:13 to play.
Miami back to the man-to-man.
And Strawberry is fouled.
Well, particularly with the game situation the way it is, Miami with the 6-point lead, you don't want to foul and allow Maryland to creep closer without the clock running.
That's what we were talking about earlier. Clemson at the top, 17-0. Clemson, Boston College, Virginia Tech, North Carolina, Virginia, all still unbeaten in conference play. Miami at 1-1. And Strawberry makes that. If you missed it, Georgia Tech beat Duke earlier tonight, so the Blue Devils are 0-2 in conference play. Strawberry makes them both. 4-point game.
Tim, foul trouble has forced Frank Hayes to play a lineup that maybe he wouldn't play at the end of the game. I specifically mean hips, but there's Harris, just takes the ball in transition. I think Maryland is actually trying to foul Hicks. 47% free throw shooter, but he did a nice job getting rid of the ball And then Harris, McClinton, Clemente really pushing it up quickly.
And Harris has been money at the free throw line.
And this, if you're Miami, this is what you want to do. Trade points because you've got the lead.
4 for 5 from the line tonight. Makes it a 54-49 game.
You'd like to play tough defense if you're the Hurricanes without fouling. Force Maryland to run as much time off the clock as possible.
Harris has scored Miami's last 6 points. 6-point game, but Maryland hasn't been able to buy a basket. Hayes penetrates and he's fouled.
Big situation for the freshman. You know, Hayes has only attempted 3 free throws all year, Tim. Made them all.
Under a minute to play, though, and no timeouts. It's critical. In a situation like this, he gets fouled, stops the clock, and closes the gap here.
Well, the problem for Maryland, they're scoring from the free throw line, and that's fine, but Miami's going down the other end, and they're answering.
Makes them both. 55-51.
You can't come back in the game if you're trading baskets.
And you don't want Harris at the line, but that's who Hayes fouls.
I think you got Clemente.
Clemente was fouled, right.
Now that may be worse. Clemente's a 77% free throw shooter. The guy you want to foul if you can get your hands on him is Hicks.
It's Clemente's first trip to the free throw line tonight. He doesn't go very often. He's 13-17 for the year. This is the first. They try to give Miami a 5-point lead here with this one. Makes the second.
And what
and
Frank
Miami Haith, takes timeout.
Well, no, they didn't take timeout, but what Frank Haith did was send dues to the scores table to report in. That makes the game stop. Miami has a chance to set the defense.
This is Jones.
Oh, he got fouled.
And he'll go to the line to shoot 3. Big, big foul.
Harris has done a really nice job for the most part since Jones got off early and hit those 3 early threes. Harris has done a nice job defending him. But that was a mistake there.
So Jones goes to the line. He's hit 6 of his 8 free throws tonight. 50 seconds left, and these now are monumental for the Maryland Terrapins.
Mike Jones shooting 3.
And it gets quiet in the Comcast Center. And he misses the first.
I still got 2 more. You know, you can't let that first miss affect you.
And if he makes the next 2, it's a 1-possession game. So Dews goes out. Back into the ballgame comes Denny Clemente. So he makes the final 2. It's a 3-point game with 50 seconds left.
You got to foul him.
And they do. And so Raymond Hicks will go to the line. And again, he's only a 47% free throw shooter.
North Carolina maintaining that number 1 rating. See, they're a 10-point victory over Virginia. Virginia led that game early. That's a pretty good North Carolina team.
And an interesting Virginia team. Had that big win over Arizona. A couple big wins this year. Hicks, a 47% free throw shooter, now 2 for 3 tonight. Miami doing what it has to do to win.
Maryland doing a nice job stretching the game out there.
Back to a 5-point game.
Boy, those are a couple of big free throws.
5-point game with 48 seconds left. Again, Strawberry is fouled and will go back to the line.
Boy, the Maryland faithful wishing that Strawberry could have put that one in the basket despite the foul so he'd have an opportunity for a three-point play.
4 for 6 at the line tonight, but he's made his last four. And misses that one.
Now, this is not going to be a game that's going to make the Maryland highlight reel, I don't think, Tim. They have been very, very frustrating for the Terrapins on the offensive end of the court.
But a huge game, Dan. You made the point early. You've got to win at home in the ACC, especially games you're supposed to win. And this was one that they really felt they should win.
Tim, I think so, but this is going to be a crazy league this year.
So McClinton will go to the line.
And that's the last guy you want to foul.
Right.
But, of course, you're to the point in the game where you really don't have much choice. You've got to stop that clock immediately. And a nice job by Hicks. He just made those two free throws, but he's still a 47% shooter, and he got rid of the ball very quickly.
And he misses.
The 47% shooter makes them both. The 91% shooter misses.
And you're right, they have extended this game. The last 9 minutes of this game have now taken 31 minutes to play.
That'll make the local news happy.
59-54 Miami. This is Jones. And that might do it.
No, I think there's a foul inside on Hicks. I think Ebekwe's going back to the line.
And you're right, it's going to stay right here. So Ebekwe will go to the line. Member of the Nigerian national team. Had a big night with blocks. Had a pretty good night at the free throw line, too, for a 62% free throw shooter at 6 for 6. Trouble is the Terrapins haven't hit him down the stretch here when they needed him. Get the roll there.
That's
make it a four-point game.
It's been a frustrating night for guys like Ebekwe and Gist around the basket, though, Tim. They, I think, missed a number of easy opportunities, opportunities that they would admit they would normally make.
Makes them both, 59-56. It's a one-possession game. And Miami takes a timeout.
Miami calls a 30-second timeout.
ACC basketball has been brought to you by Bud Light, by your Carolina Jeep dealers, by Alltel, by Food Lion, by Pepsi, and by Geico.
One possession game, 24.9 seconds left to play. Miami trying to hold on and steal one on the road. Get one game above 500, while the Maryland Terrapins, 14-2 and 11-0 at home, in serious jeopardy of dropping this one. Here we go, last 24.9 ticks. And Jones with the foul.
Sends Harris to the line. That time in the huddle, Frank Hayes drew up a play that sent Hicks down to the other end of the court, so Maryland did not have a chance to foul the worst Miami free throw shooter.
What they do is they send a senior to the line, a guy who has started 61 of his last 90 games in Miami, and he's fit 5 for 6 at the line tonight.
He's done an excellent defensive job throughout the game against Mike Jones, and he has really helped put the game away down the stretch from the free throw line.
One more quick reminder coming up Saturday at noon, NC State and Wake Forest. That game will be followed at 2 by Virginia and Boston College. Dan will be at Wake Forest. I'll be up in Boston. ACC play continues as we head toward Tampa, the ACC tournament. 61-56, 20 seconds left. Hayes got away with the carry. Good block. That'll do it. Terrapins are going to go down in flames here at the Comcast Center. That's a big win for Miami and Frank Hayes.
Well, it sure is, but keep in mind, this is a Maryland team that averages almost 82 points a game, and Frank Hayes' guys defensively have done a great job holding them to 56 points.
exactly right, Dan. And Maryland, no field goals in the last 8 minutes of the first half. No field goals in the last 9:35 of the second half. Out rebounded. Big advantage by Miami and fast break points. And they deserve this win here in College Park. Harris, 14 points. And that'll do it as we tick away the last few seconds of this game. Maryland not even close all night long. And that'll do it. 63-58 will be the final score. The Miami Hurricanes with a big win. They go to 9-8. 2-1 in the ACC. You've been watching exclusive coverage of ACC basketball on the Raycom and Lincoln Financial Sports Network. For Dan Bonner, I'm Tim.